probability, a chapter in quantitative aptitude without which quantitative aptitude is always incomplete. Before going ahead and solving some numericals, let's first understand its concept. Some of the very important aspects in its concept. Like number one is experiment. What is an experiment? An operation which can produce some well-defined outcomes is called an experiment. Next concept is about random experiment. An experiment in which all possible outcomes are known and the exact output cannot be predicted in advance is called a random experiment. Rolling an unbiased dice, tossing a fair coin, drawing a card from a pack of well-shuffled cards, picking up a ball of certain color from a bag containing ball of different colors. Let's understand in details. When we throw a coin, then either a head or a tail appears. A dice is a solid cube having six faces marked 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 respectively. When we throw a die, the outcome is the number that appears on its upper face. It might be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. Then the next experiment is, a pack of cards has 52 cards. It has 13 cards of each suit, named spades, clubs, hearts and diamonds. Cards of spades and clubs are black cards. Cards of hearts and diamonds are red cards. There are four honors of each unit. There are kings, queens and jacks. These are all called face cards. Now let's know what do we mean by a sample space. When we perform an experiment, then the set S of all possible outcomes is called the sample space. For example, in tossing a coin, the sample space are head or tail. If two coins are tossed, then sample space becomes head or head, head with tail, tail or head, or tail with tail. In rolling a dice, the sample space is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. Now after sample space, let's talk about events. Any subset of a sample space is called an event. Examples: if two coins are tossed, then how many events can give a head? Sample space here is head-head, head-tail, tail-head or tail-tail. And the event is head-head, head-tail and tail-head. From the entire sample space, only those outcomes are included in events where head is coming. Now let's see the probability of occurrence of an event. Let S be the sample and L be an event. Then probability of the event is NE by NS, number of total events by number of total sample space, with a condition that all events are a part of the sample space. Now let's see some results of probability. Probability of S equals to 1, because in probability of S, NE is equal to NS. Number of events is equal to number of sample space. So both cancels each other. So the fraction becomes 1. Next result. PE is always greater than equal to 0 or less than equals to 1. And P5 is always equal to 0. It's also called as P null, where NE equals to 0. That means there are no events which match the sample space. Next rule. For any events A and B, we have probability of A or B equals to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A and B. Fourth rule. If A denotes not A, then probability of not A equals to 1 minus probability of A. Now let's understand some problems. First question. Tickets numbered 1 to 20 are mixed up and then a ticket is drawn at random. What is the probability that the ticket drawn has a number which is multiple of 3 or 5? The options are 1 by 2, 2 by 5, 8 by 15 or 9 by 20. The right option is option D, 9 by 20. Let's see how. Here in the given experiment, the sample space is 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 20. Now the event is asking about getting a multiple of 3 or 5. So from the sample space, the numbers which are multiple of 3 and 5 are 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 5, 10 and 20. So probability of the event is NE by NS, that is equal to 9 by 20, total number of events by total number of sample space. Next example, two dice are thrown simultaneously. What is the probability of getting two numbers whose product is even? The options are 1 by 2, 3 by 4, 3 by 8 or 5 by 16. The right option is option B, 3 by 4. Let's see how. Now in the given sample space, in a simultaneous throw of two dice, we have NS equals to 6 into 6, that is equal to 36. That means if two dice are thrown, then there can be 36 results which are expected. Now the event asks that two numbers which are coming from the sample space as outcomes must have their product as even. So the possible outcomes are 1, 2, 1, 4, 1, 6, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6, 3, 2, 3, 4, 3, 6, 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6, 5, 2, 5, 4, 5, 6, 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5 or 6, 6. Hence, NE or number of events is equal to 27 and NS or total number of sample space is equal to 36. So probability is 27 by 36, that is equal to 3 by 4. Next question. From a pack of 52 cards, two cards are drawn together at random. What is the probability of both the cards being kings? The options are 1 by 15, 25 by 57, 35 by 256 or 1 by 221. The right option is option D, 1 by 221. Let's see how. Here let the sample space be S. So NS will be 52 combination 2. That means how many ways that you can draw two cards from the entire sample space of 52 cards. That is equal to 52 into 51 by 2 into 1. It is just by solving 52 combination 2, which we have earlier discussed in permutation combination chapter. The answer is 1326. Now the event asks that both the cards must be kings. So let E be the event of getting two kings out of four. So NE will be 4 combination 2. That means out of all the four kings, what is the probability of getting two kings? That is equal to 6. So probability of the event is NE by NS, that is equal to 6 by 1326, that is equal to 1 by 221. Next question. A card is drawn from a pack of 52 cards. The probability of getting a queen of club or a king of heart is, options are 1 by 13, 2 by 13, 1 by 26 or 1 by 52. The right option is option C, 1 by 26. Let's see how. Here NS equals to 52. The total number of possible outcomes in the sample space is 52. And the event demands a queen of club or a king of heart. So let E be the event of getting a queen of club or a heart of kings. Then NE equals to 2. Because there is only one queen of club and one king of heart. So either you can get a queen of club or a king of heart. So the possible outcomes are only 2. So probability of this problem is NE by NS, that is equal to 2 by 52, that is equal to 1 by 26. Next question. Two cards are drawn together from a pack of 52 cards. The probability that one is a spade and one is a heart is, the options are 3 by 20, 29 by 34, 47 by 100 or 13 by 102. The right option is option D. Let's see how. Let S be the sample space. Then NS will be equal to 52 combination 2. That means in how many ways you can draw two cards from a lot of 52 cards. This is 52 combination 2, that is equal to 1326. Now let E be the event of getting one spade and one heart. NE equals to number of ways of choosing one spade out of 13 and one heart out of 13 cards. Because there are total 13 spade and 13 hearts. So that is equal to 13 combination 1 into 13 combination 1. That is equal to 13 into 13 equals to 169. So the probability is 169 by 1326, that is equal to 13 by 102. Next example. Three unbiased coins are tossed. What is the probability of getting at most two heads? The options are 3 by 4, 1 by 4, 3 by 8 or 7 by 8. The right option is option D, 7 by 8. Let's see how. Here the sample space S is TTT or tell tell tell, tell tell head, tell head tell, head tell tell, tell head head, head tell head, head head tell or head head head. Let the event of getting at most two heads be E. Then E will be tell tell tell, tell tell head, tell head tell, head tell tell, tell head head, head tell head or head head tell. So probability of this event is number of events by number of sample space, that is equal to 7 by 8.